They also organized the marketplaces or centers where trade would take place. Lastly, the Africans collected taxes from the traders while in the market. And as we are going to see when we talk about the effects, it is from these taxes that the African kings and chiefs obtained a lot of wealth. People like Tunkamani, people like Sundiata Keita, people like Mansa Musa, people like Askia Muhammad, people like Sun Ali and others. Even the Sumanguru Kante of the Susu in the Kanyaga kingdom, they gained a lot of wealth through collecting or obtaining the taxes. As we conclude, those were the roles played by different participants in the Trans-Saharan trade. The Berbers, the Tuaregs, and the Africans, they played different roles, and those roles are like the way we have explained them above. We are now going to talk about the problems faced by the traders in the Trans-Saharan trade, the challenges, the bottlenecks, what affected their movements. Remember to introduce always. In West Africa, once you don't introduce, you are missing some marks. So introduce. Tell us what the Trans-Saharan trade was. That this was the trade. Don't say this is the trade. It was the trade that was conducted between the North African Berbers and the West African Negroes across the Sahara Desert. Tell us that these traders faced many problems. Tell us that these problems were social, political, and economic in nature. You have introduced your essay. Now go to the body and then after, conclude. So, what were the problems? They faced a problem of language barrier. Don't say they faced a problem of language. Language is not a problem, but the problem is language barrier. They faced a problem of language barrier, and this affected the communication between the traders, especially the West Africans who had not known Arabic language. They continued to use sign language, which hindered and limited the commercial activities in the Trans-Saharan trade. There was a problem of inadequate supply of some trade items. Take an example, time reached and gold from Buri and bamboo became so scarce. And for that case, there was market for gold in North Africa, but gold was not there in West Africa. So it became a very big challenge. We also faced a very big challenge of long journeys to cross the Sahara Desert. To cross the Sahara Desert. When we are talking about the Sahara Desert, this is the equatorial region. The Sahara Desert is this one. And they would cross this desert, and it would take them a lot of time to cross from west to north, and again from north to bring the salt to West Africa. And some traders would even end up dying on the way. Some traders would get so tired. Even the slaves that would be taken from West Africa, some would even die on the way because of the long journeys. They also faced a problem of poor transport facilities. Imagine moving on foot crossing the desert, the way what it would be from here up to here, it was not easy. Moving on foot. Not until the camels were introduced, but even when they were introduced, their role was not to transport the people, but to transport the commodities, meaning the people still suffered because of the poor transport facilities. There was also another problem of insecurity, especially in the northern bend of River Niger. Because of the interstate conflicts, because of the state wars, the wars between states, traders would not find it easy to cross such states. We are going to see the harsh desert storms, the strong winds in the desert that would even cover the traders with their commodities. You move and you find a strong storm of wind that carries all the sand, and it would even cover the traders. We cannot forget to talk about the harsh desert conditions. What makes the Sahara a desert is because of its climatic characteristics. So harsh, too hot during the day, and so cold at night. It becomes hot very fast and becomes so cold very fast. During the day, stepping down barefooted was so hard. The place was so hot. Even at night, it was so cold. So there was very harsh climatic conditions in the desert. The traders also faced a problem of the diseases, influenza, malaria, and others. Especially the influenza came because of the strong storms that came with dust. They also faced a problem of inadequate storage facilities, where to keep especially the perishable products. Someone wants kola nuts from West Africa, but maybe there is a market for fresh kola nuts, not the dried ones. Will it be able to reach North Africa, that kola nut, before it has maybe gotten bad? So the storage facilities were also not okay. There was also another problem of strong opposition from some of the African leaders, especially those who opposed slave trade, who pretended to be so humane that they are fighting for people. As we are going to see factors for the decline, when missionaries came to West Africa and they started decampaigning slave trade. Remember, missionaries did not stop slave trade. They only decampaigned slave trade. So people started looking at slave trade as something satanic. And because of such, it also hindered the transactions. We also had a problem of dangerous wild animals that scared the traders. Never say wild animals that killed the traders, say that scared away the traders. Check on your screen. The snakes, scorpions, hyenas. You meet such a hyena with your gold, why can't you put the gold down and you run away? Dangerous wild animals. There was another problem of shortage of water for the traders and camels to drink. Remember, this was a desert. We don't expect reliable rainfall. We don't expect rivers in the desert. For that case, we only survived on the small oases in the desert, which were so scattered. And remember, it was the work of the Tuaregs to direct these traders that please go there, there is an oasis, and you take some water. But before that, people suffered. Camels would die of thirst. We had a problem of heavy taxes that were imposed on the traders. Rich West Africa, a king tells you, please, you're supposed to pay this amount of the tax. The chief tells you, I'm collecting this amount of the tax. And you calculate the profit you're supposed to get, you find you are in a complete loss, but you have nothing to do because you have to sell and go back. Related to that, we had a problem of high interest rates charged on the loans that were given to the traders. Give you a loan, they say you're going to pay 50% interest. Not easy. So some of the traders started saying, I like the trade, but I may not afford. And others started leaving the trade for other activities as time went by. Those were the problems faced by the traders in the trans-Saharan trade, in the internal trade, in the caravan trade, in the salt gold trade. All those names can be used to mean the trans-Saharan trade. I will conclude by reminding you what the trans-Saharan trade was. As, check that definition on your screen. That trade that was conducted between the North African Berbers, Berbers were here in the north, and the West African Negroes, meaning the trade was between two major parties, two major regions, the North and West. And that was across, never say in the desert, never say along the desert, but across. That is where the word trans comes from, across the Sahara Desert. And trust me, you will be getting ticks and you are going to be the distinction one material. Let's meet in the next episode where we are going to talk about factors for the decline of this trade because it's no longer there, and then effects of the trade. Thank you.